Hi, I'm Brandon from AWeber. In this video, you'll learn how to convert a follow-up series into a campaign in AWeber. Automated campaigns allow you to deliver targeted email sequences automatically on a schedule you choose. This allows you to keep subscribers engaged and build lasting relationships with your subscribers no matter where you are or what you're doing. With campaigns, AWeber's automated email platform, you get all the automated power of a follow-up series plus so much more. If you're using our follow-up series feature, here are several reasons to switch to campaigns. First, create as many campaigns as you like on a single list. Second, target your campaigns to all subscribers or specific groups of subscribers, for example, if you have multiple sign-up forms or landing pages. Third, apply tags automatically during the sequence of your campaign. Fourth, use action-based automations, like when someone opens an email or clicks a link, to apply or remove a tag or remove them entirely from the campaign. Fifth, remove subscribers from a campaign when they're tagged outside of the campaign, for example, if they make a purchase through PayPal. Sixth, you can allow subscribers to go through your campaign multiple times. Seventh, you can add a time delay at the beginning of your campaign. Eight, you can automatically add subscribers to a campaign when they open a broadcast message or click a link in a broadcast message. And finally, number nine, you can easily pause, stop, or close a campaign. Let's dive in and I'll show you how to convert your follow-up series into a campaign in AWeber. One quick note before we dive in. If you created your AWeber account after February 3rd, 2020, you won't find the follow-up series feature in your account as we have discontinued this feature for new customers. So you'll create an automated series of messages using campaigns. Now back to converting your follow-up series into a campaign. First, you need to be able to pause your existing follow-up series. To do that, under messages, click follow-up series. Then click Show the Series in Campaigns. Clicking this button does not convert the series into a campaign. Instead, it allows you to manage the status of your follow-up series so you can pause it while you convert your series into a campaign. We'll come back to this one in a bit. Next, enable follow-up sharing below your follow-up series. To do so, simply click the toggle switch so that it is green. When follow-up sharing is enabled, your follow-up series can be imported into a campaign by entering a sharing code. Highlight the sharing code text and copy it. Control C on a PC and Command C on a Mac. Next, let's head over to the Campaigns page and pause our current follow-up series. Hover over the Messages tab and click Campaigns. To pause your follow-up series, click the Status dropdown and then select Pause Campaign. Pausing the follow-up series will prevent any new subscribers added to the list from receiving those messages, but any existing subscribers who are already in the series will continue through until they complete the series. For example, if you have 4 follow-up messages and a subscriber is on follow-up number 2, then they will continue to receive messages 3 and 4 at the wait intervals you had previously set. Once your follow-up series is paused, import your follow-up series into a campaign using your sharing code you had previously copied. Click Create a Campaign, then select Import a Campaign. Paste in your follow-up series sharing code, Control V on a PC or Command V on a Mac. Then click Import. Name your campaign and then click Create. Your follow-up series will automatically be imported as a campaign. Click Save and Exit. Next, activate your new campaign. To do so, under the Status dropdown, click Activate Campaign. Finally, after all remaining subscribers have completed your original follow-up series, you can delete it. First, you'll need to identify who is still progressing through your follow-up series. You can keep track of the subscribers by creating a segment based on their last message number. To do this, hover over Subscribers and click Manage Subscribers. Use the search options to search for Last Message Number. Then use the Is Less Than or Equal To criteria and enter the number of the next to last message in your series. For example, if you have 4 messages in your follow-up series, your next to last message would be 3. After you search, a green bar will appear with the subscribers that match the criteria. Name and save your segment. Segments are dynamic, so as subscribers reach the last message in your series, they won't be included in this segment. After a few days or weeks have passed, depending on the number of messages you have and the wait intervals, check to see if there are subscribers in your segment. If there aren't, you can delete the follow-up messages and work solely with campaigns. Now that your series is a campaign, you can begin using all the advanced automation features available with campaigns. That's it. You've successfully converted your follow-up series into a campaign, and now you can do so much more with your email automation. If you have any questions, put them in the comments below. And if you need any help, Click the link in the description to contact our award-winning customer solutions team, available 24/7. And don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications of new videos. Thanks for watching.